This is very interesting. These are the files which again were pushed out by liberation. In my memory, my half of my house had this flat. So every month of before the rain, we had to remove the whole thing and clean it, because after the rain, they should shake with the wind. So this, if you notice, they just kept on the grid. It is simply laid. There's no anchor. Now Bangalore tiles are having an anchor. They have hooks. They are hooked to the patterns. These are just kept. Now in concrete, we used to say Goa Shuntale. So we used to think, why is this term used? But when I photographed this photograph, you can see that person that actually is teaching. You can see the, look closely, you can see the thing being taken out like this. Without cutting, they take a whole spool of thread and they keep on weaving one after another. It's resembling a woman stitching. So it actually is like stitching, and all these things are clear. All these things are, this is like a stitch, you know, when they do for the skirts. And everything is stitched and not nailed, because the nails will split these bamboos. So one clue is that the nails will rust and that thing will come off. So this is the Goa Shunta term comes from this. This is what you can see in pulling the thread out. Now these tiles, I had seen a lot of them, but what was happening is every year there should be many broken. So we would then replace them with mango tiles. The reason being that these tiles are no longer made.
So what are these tiles called?
These are called country tiles. Actually, these were not made when I was there. Now, when I was doing this study, I was inquiring, and someone said that these tiles were made. My wife is from
Kapra. We had in our house in Santa Cruz.
We
stayed for 20 years. We enjoyed it. Snakes used to fall from the beauty of that, there was no waterproofing.
Yeah,
no wind, we started digging, we took the ladder and made and changed the
ladder. Yeah, just went and you have to just shake it up and push it up and down.
With a stick and a...
The young generation is not interested in these old things. Changing tiles and all.
And nowadays you find it very rare to be able to find it. So everybody has thrown them out because they're not. So he said that we should make these tiles here in this village of Kathala. Then he told me the interest, he said we should create that tiles. This fellow was
it came from Mediterranean, this tile, from Iberian Peninsula. You see such houses even today in Portugal. But different tiles. Please go ahead.
They should take a field on these. They should excavate the mud.
Any of you have such houses?
We removed and kept.
So
we already removed.
Big address, you pass that.
So what they
used to scoop
the mud and they used to mold it on a particular. Two molds were required. One was to make it flat, the second one was to make it round. Then they should bake in ovens. But the manufacturer of this tiles was huge, because 3 lakh tiles a year is quite a. And they suddenly, the mango tiles flooded the market. Everybody fancied that, because once you lay it, you don't have to repair it the next year. And so there was no demand, and that thing died. So now these few houses make a nice kind of, I think they will be there for the next 2 years, and after that they will not be for winter. So one makes them, and people will just buy from other houses if they are available. But then most of them are broken. So this is a very interesting aspect of the work.
Broken tiles we did not waste, we use it for gardening.
Yeah, vertical.
Yeah, even empty bottles we used to use for gardening.
Yeah.
So that is another craftsmanship we will talk later. Next. These workers are from where? Durba, Dagapur area?
They go to which?
Those Shivdalish.
They are from Nadora.
Huh?
Nadora.
Yeah,
that's a house in Nadora, and I went to his house afterwards and I spoke with him. Then he told me the details about how much he used to be. Not so interesting. This is the.
Please don't talk.
This is the.
Focus on Nagalega.
This is Shindrish. What happens is when we cut a palm leaf, we used to cut it initially for various reasons. One was to catch the
out. Palm means billamar,
eriota? No.
Coconut.
Coconut.
So to catch our houses. And we used to cut a few extra to convert it into brooms. So those were taken, and we used to just remove the weed, whatever used to come, we should remove the weed. And then they should smoothen them and make broom. The rest of the staff was discarded. Now when I went to Kotigao, I saw this mat being made. I had this mat. plants are not usually found in our villages of Salsette, etc. So I was wondering how it is done. So she explained that after removing the wheel, the whatever remains that they use, they cut it properly, they cut it in the size of his band, you can see. And they just cut them and they dry them and they keep them. Now, what we do here, the minute we are going to watch TV or go on laptops or WhatsApp, what they do is they just come out and sit with this. And they keep on spinning, I mean, weaving this into this roll. This roll is called as the part. And there is no limit to it. They keep on going. Now, they just keep it like bales. The minute they finish, this things are done, then they cut them into sizes required for the height of men, 6 feet or 7 feet, and width depending on whether it's a single or a couple, and then they join these two together like this. And the joints are so perfect that you cannot make out where it is joined. If you look at the back, you can see where it is joined. So, what we throw off are converted into mats by all these religious women who are the tribal women, and they are sitting in the beautiful courtyard of Kavada.
So, even your names, now, if any of you would like to be apprenticed with this, because we can arrange it, spend a summer apprenticeship or winter apprenticeship to learn this art, which is thousands of years old.
And once this is done, it makes beautiful curtains. It can be rolled around a bamboo and you can use it to shield the
people. Eco-friendly.
Absolutely. Another thing that I would advocate is when people have any function nowadays, they simply go to a big printer and they buy that flex sheet, and who is benefiting the flex manufacturers? Say, if it are multinationals, the machine makers who are multinationals, and the people who are invested in that, who are also quite well off. But what I would say, instead of doing all that plastic stuff, the minute a function is over, that's a big liability to the to nature. And it is dumped here and dumped there, and finally it finds its way into the garbage. If you take these mats and you just write on them what is happening now, if it is a lecture, just write a lecture is happening, people will appreciate, people will see handwritten stuff and not printed stuff. So I always advocate to buy these mats and take the watercolors and tell a child or tell an artist, ordinary artist, to write what's happening behind all that and put it up. It looks friendly, will be helping these people. After it is done, you can just buy it, print it, keep it for the next time. In the meantime, you can use a mat to sit down. Various things. It is also so soft that you can sit on it without getting all marks on your body. We have these plastic mats that we made it sometime back. There you get all these slip bare on those mats, you get all these marks. They are very soft. You don't get it. And they also smell nice, soft, tender. So this is the shenri. So they stitch that end of it, and you see in the shenri. The stitching is done, see, parents, you can make out the joint. Examine closely, you can't see a joint. It's like magic that it is done. They also use a community bark to stitch the joints together.
In the emporium, this is sold in Kalangut, Kandalam area. This is sold for 5,000 rupees, this size. You must be purchasing for 50 rupees and selling for 5,000.
Anybody is familiar with this?
Sunagat.
Pishol. The traditional brush.
Now, in my place, we had a roof which was quite high. So, and we should just bypass the entire back of the house every year. So, imagine taking a ladder and going up and brushing it in the small strokes. So these people have come up with this beautiful tool which has got a huge handle, and you can, no ladder they can use. The workpiece is so fast, there is no ladder involved. This part of this top part is made out of
coir.
No.
Soon.
Kedaji art matter.
I see.
The minute you get bananas and you throw out at stem, these people would go and you collect it, dry it. And they cut it into four parts. And they take this bamboo and they just put it in the middle and they wrap it around. And then they tie it up. They have a nice art to tie it up. They tie it in various ways for length and for releasing extra lengths of the brushing area. Once they brush, because it is very soft, it gets worn out. After some time it gets worn out, they release one. It's there in the book edition actually. They release a smaller part and more portion is released. So, after some days it's gone, then you take another one. Major portion is the bamboo, and the bamboo used to glisten, you can see your face there because of the polishing, fast, etc. gets polished to such an extent that you can see a piece in there. This is another another beautiful art which we have completely lost. Now this person, Mayur Athos, is my from Bayonne. When I met him, he had this brush, fortunately, and I got photograph it. I had to give a presentation for Vaikarat Dai in Margao. So I thought I would invite him and make him sit in the audience and show the brush. So I went to his place, he said, no, sit in the white. Probably the last one. Gilead is a Kasar from Kumbali. He is a god, his ancestral army is blacksmiths. They are owning their own properties and they are quite happy. You can see they are quite happy. Now what is happening is, this Gilead had, at the time when I went to him, he had two sons who were very capable. They are both done their well.
Just one question. How you understood that they are happy? Why they are happy?
I can see the smile on his face.
Then they knew because they were photographing.
No, but then I also know the background.
This is the poverty. I don't think any poor person in the world will be happy. Poverty is the biggest, you know, impediment to one's happiness.
But they are poor, but they are not starving. They are doing quite well. And his sons are 12 children, well fed. They both look like mini horses. Very handsome, good looking guys. So he says, now his daughter is pulling the bells.
If you are good looking, you are happy.
I can do that. This is, she's pulling the bells. And,